Hello everyone. Sexual desire is something that any man or woman can have, and it is not subject to judgment as right or wrong because it is a thought that belongs to only one's own mind. Sexual desire, as well as appetite and the desire for achievement, is energy that seeks to fill in, compensate for, or develop something that is missing in order to live happily. Therefore, the first premise is that an individual's sexual desire is no one's business to judge or interfere with, unless it is misguidedly expressed outwardly and causes harm to others. Sexual desire can always be converted into the desire to pursue values of life. However, there are some people whose thoughts remain stuck on sexual desire. This is usually the case for men who are unable to pursue their values and heal from stress, or for women who are in an unstable state in the pursuit of meanings in their lives and have many wounds. Overly focusing on sexual desire can lead to a life of pursuing only sex as the manifestation of sexual desire. However, sexual desire can also be used as a great source of energy for happiness. Some people self-impose abstinence because they believe that having sex wastes energy that could be spent for other fulfillments. From the perspective of the theory of my mind and this mind, this is actually not a suppression of desire, but rather a transformation of desire into the energy of value pursuit. For men, for whom having sex is actually only a temporary outlet for their sensory organs, there is only a small and temporary loss of energy, not enough to be called a waste. In fact, when men have passionate sex with someone they love and protect, this energy is actually used to fuel their passion for future happiness. And this energy can be used to better pursue their values of life. However, when a man has reckless sex with a woman he doesn't love and protect, his zest wounds grow to be excessive, causing damage to the body and leading to sexual dysfunction and somatization. Men are usually very passionate about their value pursuits, and when they put all their energy into them day and night, they have no reason to think about sex. When they stop pursuing their values in life for a moment, the energy that they put into them becomes disoriented and they feel sexual desire. But when they return to their value pursuits, sexual desire disappears again soon. Women too will no longer feel lonely or in need of love and attention from other people if they allow the sexual energy to work on their own emotions and create their own happiness. The important thing is to accurately know the nature of sexuality, which creates human energy, and the nature of the mind so that we can put that energy to good use constructively. If you don't know the nature of sexuality and the mind, and you practice abstinence just by suppressing your sexual desire, it is very likely that the opposite force will come into play and your desires may be distorted and expressed in actions that cause harm to yourself and others. If you are considering trying abstinence for any reason, it's good to know that it is possible to have a fully satisfying sex life with someone you love and protect and still live happily with the great energy of passion that your happy sex life creates.